Hello everyone, welcome to Emmanuel Tutorials. Today we'll see some problems related to periodic and non-periodic signals. So the first example which we have is x of t is equal to cos 2 pi t the whole square. Now we cannot solve it using this original form, so we'll use the trigonometric formula for cos theta, cos square theta. Now we know that cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So in this case, our theta is 2 pi t. So our x of t will become 1 plus cos 4 pi t by 2. This can be also written as cos square 2 pi t. So that's why we are using this formula. Now if we separate this, it will become half plus half cos 4 pi t. So in this case, this is a DC signal with frequency 0 and this is a sinusoidal cos signal. So we'll use this part of the signal to find the fundamental period. So in the previous class, we saw that omega is equal to 2 pi by t, which is the fundamental period. So if we rearrange it, the fundamental period will be 2 pi by omega. So in this case, our omega is 4 pi because it can be written as cos of omega t. So at time period will be, fundamental period will be 2 pi by 4 pi. So it will be 1 by 2. Now always we must remember that our period should be a ratio of integers and the value should be a rational number. So here we have got 1 by 2, so we can say that this is a periodic signal with fundamental period as half. So in all these problems, we'll be trying to find out if it is a periodic or non-periodic signal and the fundamental period. Let's go to the next example. The next example is x of t is equal to summation k running from minus 5 to plus 5 omega t minus 2k, where omega t, which is the original signal, is this. Now let's draw the axis for the resultant signal. Now we know that the whole signal is going to run from minus 5 to 5, but the k is going to be 5 into 2, which is 10. So minus 10 to plus 10. So this whole omega t is going to get shifted to minus 10 and plus 10. So let's draw the points. Now, if we consider the point minus 5, it will be omega of, if we expand this, it will be omega t minus 10 plus omega t minus 2 into minus 2 into 4 so omega t minus 8 plus omega t minus 6 plus omega t minus 4 plus omega of t minus 2 plus omega of t plus omega t plus 2 plus omega of t plus 4 plus omega of t plus 6 plus omega of t plus 8 plus omega of t plus 10. So let's try to draw the signal. Let's first draw omega of t. Omega of t is stretching from minus 1 to plus 1 with an amplitude of 1. So this is our x of t. Now to the left hand side of omega t we have omega of t minus 2, which is a delay. So this signal will shift to the right by 2. So minus 1 plus 2 will give us 1. So it will be this kind of a signal. So 1 plus 2 will give us 3. So the second point will appear here. So this is the next. And to the right hand of omega t, we have omega t plus 2, which is a shift by 1 again in the advancing part, so which is to the left hand side of the axis. Similarly, the other. So omega t minus 4. T minus 4 will be a shift of 4 to the left hand, to the right hand side. So minus 1 minus 4 minus 1 plus 4, which will give us 3, and 1 plus 4, which will give us 5. Similarly, and this signal is going to continue till plus 10 to the right hand side and minus 10 to the left hand side. So can we say that this signal is periodic? So if we shift this signal to the left by the amount which is repeating, which is 2, will we get the original signal back? We will not be able to get the original signal back because this is a limited signal which is going to stop at 10. So if we shift it to the left by 2, this signal will stop at 8. And here the signal will shift and it will reach minus 12. So this is not the same as the original signal which we had. So this is not an example of a periodic signal. So here we don't need to find the fundamental period. So this is an aperiodic signal. Now the next example is x of t is equal to summation k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity omega of t minus 3k. And here we are again going to use the same signal as omega t. Now let's try to expand this equation. It's going to stretch till minus infinity to on the left and to plus infinity on the right. So this will continue and then we'll again write the same previous equations. So it will be omega of t minus, if we consider one of the limits as minus 3 in between and then plus 3, here. So it will be 3 into 3. So it will be minus 3 plus 3, which is t plus 9, plus omega t plus 3 into 2, which is 6, plus omega t plus 1 into 3, which is 3, plus omega t minus 3 into 0, which is t, plus omega t minus 3, plus omega t minus 6, plus omega of t minus 9, plus so on. If we try to draw the signal, this is omega t. Now next this portion of the signal is going to appear at omega t plus 3. So shifting this by 3 to the left hand side, we'll get minus 1 minus 3, which is minus 4. So the next point will be here. 0 will appear at 0 minus 3 here, and 1 will appear at 1 minus 3, which is minus 2. Similarly, on the right hand side, next it will appear at 2 plus 3, which is 5, and 4 plus 3, which is 7, and similarly on the left hand side. And this will continue to minus infinity and plus infinity. Now this signal, if we try to shift similar to the previous signal, it will be the same as x of t, because it is going to stretch from minus infinity to plus infinity. See here, what will be the fundamental period? It will be the amount of signal which is repeating. So is this part of the signal repeating again after 0? No. So from 0, if we consider from minus 1 to plus 1, is this part repeating again? No. So from minus 1 to 2, if we consider this part of the signal, it's repeating again at 2. So this duration, which is from minus 1 to 2, which is 3, is the fundamental period. So the fundamental period is 3 seconds. So this is a periodic signal with fundamental period as 3 seconds. Now let us consider the next example. X of n is equal to minus 1 raised to n. Now this is a discrete time example. So let's draw the n axis and draw some points. 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. And this is x of n. Now, if we need to draw the signal, we just have to substitute the value of n at each point. So, at 0, the value of n is 0. So, minus 1 raised to 0 will be 1. So, here it will be a signal with amplitude 1. At 1, n is 1. So, minus 1 raised to 1 is minus 1, which will be this kind of a signal. At 2, it will be minus 1 raised to 2, which is minus 1 square, which is 1. At 3, it will be minus 1 raised to 3, which is again minus 1. And similarly, at minus 1, it will be minus 1 raised to minus 1, which is as good as 1 upon minus 1, which is equal to minus 1. So here, the value is going to be minus 1. At minus 2, the value will be minus 1 raised to minus 2, so which is 1 upon minus 1 the whole square, which is 1 upon 1, which is 1. So it will be 1, again minus 1, again 1, and which is going to continue to both sides. Now, we can see that this part of the signal is repeating after a particular interval. So, from 0 to 2 is the fundamental period. So, 2 samples is the fundamental period for this signal, because after 2 we are able to again see the original part of the signal back. Now let's consider the next example. X of n is equal to minus 1 raised to n square. So this can be rewritten as minus 1 raised to 2n, because power is power multiplied. And this can be also written as minus 1 square raised to n, which is equal to 1 raised to n, because minus 1 square is 1. And 1 raised to anything is 1. So if we try to draw the signal, the horizontal axis is n. This is x of n, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. So if we try to draw the signal, it will be a 1. At x of 0, at n equal to 0, it's going to be 1. At n equal to 1, it's again going to be 1. At n equal to 2, it's again going to be 1. Similarly, this is going to continue. Now, this is an example of a DC signal in discrete time. So, a DC signal has frequency of 0. So it has time period of infinity, and this is a non-periodic signal. Because it will take infinite time for the whole signal to repeat. Now let's consider the next example. X of n is equal to this signal. So here we can see from minus 1 to plus 1, there are 3 signals. Then at 2 points, there is no signal again. So if we name this, so at 4 and 5, there are 2 signals. Then again at 3 points, there are no signals. So at 9, 10 and 11, there are signals. Similarly on the left hand side. So at 3 points, we don't have a signal. At minus 5 and minus 6, we have signals. And similarly here, minus 9, minus 10, minus 11. Now we can see that this signal is stretching from minus infinity to plus infinity. Also, this whole part, that is from minus 1 to plus 9, is repeating to the next interval. That is, how many samples are repeating? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So at 9, you can see the repetition of this first point again. So 10 samples are repeating. So the fundamental period is 10 samples. And it is a periodic signal. Now this next example, again this x of t is stretching from minus infinity to plus infinity. Here we have a signal with amplitude minus 1 from minus 1 to plus 1, and from plus 3 to plus 5 we have a signal with amplitude plus 1. Similarly, from plus 7 to plus 9 we have a signal with amplitude plus 1. Similarly, minus 3 to minus 5, minus 7 to minus 9, and so on. We can see that this signal stretches from minus infinity to plus infinity, but in this duration there is a signal which is not matching the other parts of the signal, because if we shift the signal by a particular value of capital T, we'll not get the original signal back. If this signal was of such a kind where from minus 1 to plus 1 we had a positive value of signal, if this was plus 1, then this would be a periodic signal. So this is an aperiodic or non-periodic signal. Now let's consider the next example. X of n is equal to cos 2n. Now for these kind of examples, we have to find out the fundamental period. So here we have capital N equal to 2 pi by omega. Here omega is 2. So here it will be 2 pi by 2, which is pi. So if we consider this ratio, it is pi by 1. So this pi is an irrational number. So we can conclude that this is an aperiodic signal, because it should be a ratio of rational numbers, then this signal would be a periodic signal. Now for the last example, x of n is equal to cos 2 pi n. Now let's use the same method. Capital N is equal to omega, in this case is 2 pi. So 2 pi by 2 pi, which is 1 by 1. Now both 1 are rational numbers, so this is a periodic signal with fundamental period as 1 sample. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any doubts or suggestions for new videos, you could mention it in the comments below. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel for new videos. Thank you.